Hello everyone, I am Gökhan, and today we will discuss circular motion and the Newton's laws and their applications. Now, we have a ball in here and it rotates around the stick with the angular velocity omega. And the question is asked us, what is T1, what is T2, and what is omega mean? So to the T2 not equal zero and the movement circles rotates like that. Now, I'm suggesting you to pause the video and solve this question by yourself. Okay, now we can solve the problem. Let's see. There is a ball and it moves like the with the omega angular velocity. Now we should firstly draw the free body diagram for this ball. Let's see. It's assume it's a point. Now the force applied by its from this rope is T1 and from this rope is T2. Also, the ball has mg for the bottom side. So the force exerted on this ball is mg at the vector notation and the T2 at the T1. The vector notation. Yes. Now assume these angles are theta and these two theta. Now we can solve this question. Firstly, we should split up these forces to the y direction and the x direction. So we can understand what is the total force in the x direction and the y direction. And then we see this rotation. We see this ball rotates around an x-axis and never changes position from the y-axis. So also it's when we consider it doesn't have any vertical speed. So its forces exerted on this ball at the y-axis should be equal to zero. So let's see what is the y-axis forces. So when we look at there, we see this angle is theta. At the y-axis, y-component of the T1 is sin theta, cosine theta times T1. So we can write here, T1 y-axis equals cosine theta times T1, so T1 times cosine theta. Yes. Now, what is the force exerted on the by the rope T2 in the y-axis? So we can show it in here. And sorry, let me draw it in the best way. This is T2 and this is the y component of the T2. So this angle is again theta, and we see this angle is not theta, but this angle is theta. So this angle is theta too. Therefore, also again the y component of the T2 is T2y equals T2 times cosine theta. And also there is a force exerted by the gravitational acceleration. So when I sum up these forces, T1 cosine theta in positive y-axis minus T2 cosine theta, also minus mg equals zero. From that we can see take the mg from the other side and we see T1 plus T2 equals mg times mg over cosine theta. So we obtain an equality. Now we should consider the also centripetal force too. Now in order to keep his angular motion, this ball, it should be exerted by the centripetal force. So what is the centripetal force? We can calculate it by n times omega square times r. R is the distance between this ball and the stick. So this is equals to what is the x components of the exerted to this ball? They are actually you can see here This one, since this is T2, this is T2, this is angle is theta, so T2 times sine theta. And what is the other force exerted by the T1? Also again, it's same as that the T2, T1 times sine theta. Because this force is T1 and this angle is theta, so T1 times sine theta gives me the x component. So I'll put another equals in here, m omega square times r equals to T1 times sine theta and plus T2 times sine theta. Now also I can keep this T1 and T2 alone. So I can see T1 plus T2 equals, oh sorry, I will do it that. This should be T1 minus T2. So T1 plus T2 equals m omega square r over sine theta. Now, to find T1 and T2, I have two equations. And when I sum up these two equations, I obtain 2 times T1. I can move all this down. So 2 times T1 equals mg cos theta, mg over cos theta, and plus m omega square r over sine theta. And then I take this to the right side, this 2 coefficient, it should be 1 over 2 times this. So when I find T1, also I can substitute this T1 to another equation that I want, and I can obtain the T2 as well. So see what is T2 there here. Let's use this equation. So I substitute T1, this equation instead of T1. So this mg cos theta over 2, and then I take this here T2 and the mg cos theta here. So minus. First, write this m omega square r over 2 sine theta. I get 1 half of mg cos theta here, and when I take this to other side, mg cos theta, it should be minus sign. So minus mg over 2 cos theta here. And when I see this equation, this is equals to T2. Yes. Now I find T1 and T2. With these equations. Now, final questions. What should the omega mean to T2 still exist? And this, you know, the tension in the rod. So, exist to T2, m omega square r over 2 sine theta, and minus this should be greater or equal to mg over cos 2 cos theta should be greater or equal to 0. So this means I can find omega by leave it alone. So what is omega? Actually, omega square equals I can cut this alone, and when I take this mg over cos theta here, also I can get the sin theta here, so equals mg tangent theta. Here I got. So while I lift it, also mr over mr. This is the omega mean since I leave it here because this is the greater or equal to. Now I directly equated it to zero, this equation. So this should give me to omega mean. And the omega mean equals square root of mg tangent theta over mr. As. This is the question. I hope it will be beneficial for you. So take care.